हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सिविल दुनिया। दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ मॉड्यूल 3 इन विच वी विल गोइंग टू स्टडी डेली सेल्स, बेस लाइनिंग सिस्टम्स, स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ स्लोप्स, कंस्ट्रक्टिंग एस्पेक्ट्स। ओके, सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ मॉड्यूल 3। डेली सेल डिज़ाइन फॉर ए लैंडफिल is analyzed from the viewpoint of minimizing the use of daily cover soil. The landfill's daily cell is idealized to be in the shape of a parallelopiped to minimize cover soil use and for fixed values of the working face length, volume of refuse and slope of compaction. The optimal ratio of length to height for the daily cell is found to be the slope gradient, that is horizontal to vertical. For this optimum ratio, an equation is provided relating the soil to refuge ratio to daily cell design parameters. For situations away from the optimum length to height ratio, an equation is provided to estimate the excess soil required. These equations can help designers evaluate trade-offs when a designer attempts to minimize cover soil use. Landfill baselining systems provide permanent protection of soils and groundwater from the pollutants in waste mass. Lining system requirements are often specified in national regulations, and geosynthetics have become common components of these systems. Geosynthetics fulfill the stringent containment parameters of landfill liner regulations. Geosynthetics provide an efficient, significantly effective and durable barrier for long-term environmental protection. But achieving this effectiveness requires proper design, specification and installation of the geosynthetic system. To remove waste for repair or remediation of an improperly designed or executed barrier system is technically difficult and expensive. The geosynthetics utilized in a baselining system must be made from high quality raw materials. The geosynthetics must be highly resistant to chemical and biological attack. For side slopes, the polymeric barriers must have the proper frictional characteristics for geosynthetic and geosynthetic soil. Understanding how to properly evaluate and select these materials will prevent unacceptable creep or the development of tensile stresses in the system. Creep and unpermitted stress could lead to slope instability and possible failure. The thickness of geomembranes in a baselining system is generally established in regulations. In the United States, for example, primary commonly called for 1.5 mm HDPE geomembranes. In Germany, 2.5 mm is standard. In other European countries such as the UK, 2 mm thick HDPE geomembranes are used. Compared to general construction solutions like an asphalt layer, both of these geosynthetic thickness ranges are significantly more cost effective and they are far more impermeable and durable in containment. In many countries, geosynthetic clay liners, GCLs, are also permitted to be used in a landfill lining system as an alternative to clay mineral layers. System may also include non-woven geotextiles to protect impermeable barrier materials from installation damage and ballast-related overstressing. Protection layers are determined by the height of the landfill and the grain size and configuration of the drainage layer. Non-woven geotextiles may also act as a separation and filtration layer between the mineral drainage layer and the waste. Carbofull HDPE geomembranes provide high chemical and biological resistance and exceptional long-term service lives for landfill security. Smooth-surfaced carbofull geomembranes may be used on slopes up to approximately 1:9. Textured carbofull geomembranes are used for steeper slopes. Bentofix geosynthetic clay liners are composite materials made of two layers of geotextile cover and carrier layers that encapsulate a core of highly swellable powder sodium bentonite. Needle punching of the geotextiles in manufacturing firmly bonds the layers across the entire surface of the GCL. This prevents bentonite erosion and increases the durability of the material. Bentofix GCLs are used as a mineral sealing layer in geosynthetic barrier designs. Securtex nanowoven geotextiles are mechanically bonded to provide highly durable protection and long-term separation and filtration functionality. A variety of geotextile weights such as 1.2 gram per square meter and 300 gram per square meter provides robust protection and optimal separation and filtration design usage. Securtex enables engineers to specify the appropriate nanowoven to meet landfill performance needs and product approval authority guidelines. SecuGrid and CombiGrid geogrids redistribute loads to stabilize and strengthen soil layers. This includes enabling the construction of steep embankments. Now we will going to learn what is slope instability and what causes it. Okay. Slope stability means a slope moves downhill. A more descriptive term might be slope instability, since this is the problem. The general population calls this a landslide or mudslide or a rock slide, depending on the material in the slope. Usually the slope moves quickly downhill, however slow movements occur and these can be just as dangerous and costly. Gravity pulls the soil down with more force than the strength of the soil holding the soil in place. The soil strength can be reduced by water in the slope from rainfall, leaking pipes, filtration from runoff and other sources. The presence of water reduces the effective stresses between soil particles, reducing the strength as well as increasing the weight of the slope. Where are the slope stability problems in landfills? Slope failures may occur in the soil, in the waste, at the geosynthetic waste interface, or in the combinations of the soil and waste and geosynthetic. The slope that must be checked are bare soil slope after excavation, soil slope with lining system in place, soil slope with lining system in place and some waste in place, waste slope stability inside the landfill when waste is being placed below grade, waste slope stability when the waste is being placed above grade, cover slope stability when the waste is being placed above grade, waste and cover slope stability when the waste is being placed above grade. Here are the landfill slope failure modes. This one is the sidewall slope and base failure. You can see here the failure through the waste liner and foundation. Okay. Pull out of liner system components from anchor trenches. This one is failure through the waste pile. This one is the failure by sliding along the landfill liner systems. What are the examples of possible landfill slope failures? When under construction, the soil on the sides of the landfill may fail before waste is placed. These failures may be quick since the soil was unloaded quickly. When the lining system is placed on the side slopes of the landfill, the lining system may fail. Any of the several components, liner, drainage layer, or filter protection layer may fail. There must be adequate friction cohesion anchorage of the lining components to keep them in place. The waste may fail when placed in the landfill. The failure plane may be at or within the lining system or in the soil underneath. The weight of the waste may cause any of these failures. Infinite slope failure. Here is the equation to find out Fs, which is soil, which is the ratio of soil shear strength and minimum strength required for stability. एफ एस इज इक्वल टू 10 phi dash by 10 alpha s. Here you can see the terms. Okay. For short term stability, we use the undrained shear strength and perform a similar analysis. This one is rotational slope failure, and here is the equation. Fs is equal to resisting force by driving force. Okay. You can see here, this one is the sliding mass, this one is the this is the normal forces and this is the weight of the soil. Anchor trench pull out failures. The geosynthetic lining systems component geomembrane, geonet, geogrid, GCL are placed in anchor trenches at the top of the slope to resist geosynthetic sliding downhill. You can see here, there is anchor trench backfill, this is geomembrane cap strip, and cut through all geosynthetics down to mid plane of GCL. Here is a case study of Kettleman Hills West landfill, 15 acre failure. Slope height is 90 feet, bowl shaped volume, side slopes are 2 horizontal and 1 vertical to 3 horizontal to 1 vertical. Waste placement began in 1987, failure occurred on March 1988, leachate pumping 4500 gallon per month, 20 inch average leachate level in LCS. This is the Kettleman Hills landfill. So the landfill on Kettleman Hills. This is the plan view of Kettleman Hills landfill. This one is the elevation view. Thanks for watching this video. If you gain some knowledge from this video, please like it and subscribe this channel, and stay tuned with this channel for more videos on civil engineering and also to continue the series of environmental geotechnics. Thanks for watching.